It's time for the match game, Hollywood Squares. Our weird from another world, David Oliver. From We've Done It Made, Teri Copley.
We thank you for the warmth of your welcome.
And you know, there are several hunks over there, Gene. We have Matt and David. When you and I get over there, it's going to be devastating.
That's right. The four of us are going to be too much, aren't we? Well, let's get over there and make it too much. Let's say hello, stars.
Hello.
Very good. Thank you. Are the stars all ready to have a go at it?
Are ready.
Nedra, that's a smashing outfit you're wearing.
You like it,
yes.
Huh? How about us tonight, Leah?
Yeah. Okay. It's you and me after the show, right?
Why not?
Okay.
A little trouble with that door, huh?
Yeah,
what
the door just
lose?
Doesn't seem to open wide enough for it, so I tried to get it open a little wider. I'm glad you didn't take a deep bow when you came out. Simple curtsy was all we needed from you, Teri.
Some of us are too rough.
We appreciate your costume.
Nice.
I am being nice. I think you're beautiful and gifted and talented. And what else can I say?
I think you've said enough.
Okay, what do you say? We say hello to our two players here, Claudia Mueller and Sherry Lowry. Applause. All right. Let's get acquainted. Claudia, we're going to find out about you first.
Well, I'm a native of California, and I was born in a car on the freeway, so I think that's why I like to travel so much.
You were born in a car on the freeway?
A moving car on the freeway on the way to the hospital.
A moving car?
And there was a detour.
And that's why you were born in the car?
That was it.
Your mother was on the way to the hospital, is that it?
That's right. That's right. And my father's a physician, so that's why he said there was no hurry to leave.
Oh, your father was in the car?
Yeah, well, he was driving, yes.
Oh.
So anyway, that was the start of my traveling career, and since then I've sailed around the world. And now my husband Thomas and I live in Irvine, where I work as a realtor.
You mean you literally sailed around the world?
Well, it was a passenger ship, but we did, you know, we were floating.
Circumnavigated the globe in a vessel.
That's accurate.
All right, Claudia. Good luck to you here. Now let's get acquainted with Sherry. Tell us about you.
I'm a homemaker, mother of three, and I sell children's shoes part-time.
Sell children's shoes?
Yes.
Okay, Sherry, good luck to both of you.
You?
Now, you'll have three chances to match as many of the stars as you can, and the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner and go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Claudia, you won the toss. You go first.
I'll go with A, please.
A it is for her. What does A say? A says this. Vinny is speaking.
Vinny.
And Vinny said, hey, my neighborhood is so tough, an Avon lady knocked on my door, but she wasn't selling makeup, she was selling blank. Yeah. You like to read it, eh? All right, here we go, Claudia. Vinny said, my neighborhood is so tough, an Avon lady knocked on my door, but she wasn't selling makeup, she was selling blank.
Guns.
Guns. Okay. I suppose that's kind of a bad response. Guns. David?
Well, I was going to say guns, but I took it a step further. I said missiles.
Missiles. Aha. David is a star, and you're booing him. And David is on the program that precedes this one, Another World.
That's why I said missiles.
That's why I said.
I see. Okay.
Nosedive.
Deep and provides a good lead-in for us, hopefully. Nedra.
Well, the same old kind of answer I always give. Companionship.
She wasn't selling makeup, she was selling companionship.
Well, she was a... Oh, okay, figure it out yourself.
Nedra. You are a weirdo, Nedra.
I know.
She's a lady for a different time slot.
Well.
Well.
I said that she was selling a gun.
A gun? Have you enjoyed this experience? It's the first game show you've done, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Have you had a good time?
I have.
Has everyone been nice to you?
Yes.
Good. Thank you. All right. She wasn't selling makeup. She was selling guns.
One of the most popular answers on this show is buns. That didn't seem to apply, so I just rhymed it.
Done. Here's the Claudia. Leah.
Well, I figured I'd want to invest in some protection from guns, so I said mace.
Mace. All right, that would be a tough thing to sell. Yeah, that's good.
Well, I was in the same ballpark as guns. Fortunately, I put bulletproof vests.
Bulletproof vests.
That's a tough neighborhood.
That would be a big seller in a tough neighborhood, Matt. All right, now, Sherry, let's see what we have for you here in this round one question. The kids in Beverly Hills are really spoiled. Spoiled rotten. Instead of playing kick the can, they play kick the blank. Give her a little help. She's a nifty kid and a peachy dancer. Okay.
That's good.
That's good. Sherry. The kids in Beverly Hills are really spoiled. Instead of playing kick the can, they play kick the blank.
Car?
Kick the car. All right. Now, before you start booing any answers here, well, we'll solve the problems as we come to them. David.
Well, I thought this was a real bad answer, but I don't know if it's a match or not. I said Mercedes.
That's it. All right, Nedra.
Another rotten answer. How about that?
Yes.
Kick the cop.
Kick the cop. You're okay, Nedra.
Terrible neighborhood.
Right. Teri, what'd you say?
Well, I said kick the bank.
Kick the bank. The rich kids. Rich, spoiled kids.
Don't boo me.
She's very sensitive. You mustn't boo her. Instead of playing kick the can, they play kick the what, John?
Okay, judges, this one's for you. Limo.
Two to two to score now. All tied up here in the first round. What do you say, Leah?
I got real specific, too, and said Mercedes.
Mercedes. Yeah. All right, Matt, you're going to...
Okay. I've got the big-time answer on this one.
The big-time answer.
Kick the Perrier.
Kick the Perrier. That would have been my choice.
Is that right? That's the first thing that came into mind.
First thing that came to my mind, too. Kick the Perrier, because, you know, it's conceivable you could play kick the Perrier bottle just the way you play kick the can. All right. 2-3, the score. Sherry's ahead. Round two coming up in a moment or so. First, this for you. We're going to go with round two now. Sting. Sting. Sherry, you're ahead. You have to go first.
I'll take B, please.
All right. Let's see what B says. Jake said, I just saw some graffiti in the men's room that was really old.
Old.
Thank you for your help. Here's how old this was. It said, for a good time, call blank. Ready, Teri?
Are you ready for me?
Yes. Ready for you? Okay, Sherry.
Oh, you're so nice.
Jake said, I just saw some. Is there another program going on that I'm not aware of here?
It's a mini-series over here.
Jake said, I just saw some graffiti in the men's room that was really old. It said, for a good time, call blank.
Marilyn Monroe.
Marilyn Monroe.
I have no idea.
Well, anything in the past is something that would work here. It just depends on how far in the past you want to go. Nedra?
I never should have eaten, you know?
Yeah. The food wasn't bad.
Call the operator.
Oh, that's a good
call.
For the good time, if you want the good time, call the operator.
Right.
Oh, forget it.
Yeah. You know, the Meridian 71212 or whatever the time number is. Yeah. Right. Teri.
Well, I thought the way she did, only I went the opposite way. I said call Ethel.
Ethel. Is that a friend of yours?
No, it's an old name.
Oh, it's an old name, a biblical name, I suppose. All right. Now, one more person has to respond here, and that's Matt.
Just
what
me,
do you
yeah.
say?
Well, compared to those two, I think I'm going to come out sailing pretty good on this one, but Ronald Reagan.
Yeah. We become more illogical as we go along. I don't understand that completely. I'm not going to ask about that either. So, let's see now what we have for Claudia. You remain at three, Sherry, and Claudia has a chance to catch up. From miles or miles around, dogs are attracted to ugly Edna. That's because ugly Edna's legs look like blanks. Terry and John do not play. All right.
Never work again,
then. Claudia, from miles around, dogs are attracted to ugly Edna. That's because ugly Edna's legs look like blanks.
Trees.
Okay. Trees it is. That's a response. David, trees.
I think that I shall never see.
Hydrant.
Hydrant. Artwork, too. Good. Nedra?
Tree trunk.
Tree trunk, there's a match. It's up to three. The score is tied. 3-3. And Leah, what do you say?
Claudia moves ahead. Tree trunks.
Aha! 4-3. Okay, Matt, baby.
I'm on a roll now.
You're on a roll?
Fire hydrants.
Let's change the fire hydrants for the two good responses there. So it's a very tight game. The lead keeps changing hands. 4-3 the score at the end of the second round. Third and final round coming up right after this. So you have to go first.
I'll take B this time.
B. Is that what you said?
Yes.
All right. Hey, have you heard that the post office is updating all of their equipment? Now they have a machine that will automatically blank your packages. Yeah. All right, we're all set for you. Claudia? Have you heard that the post office is updating their equipment? Now they have a machine that will automatically blank your packages.
Open your packages.
Open? Why would you say that? What traditional things does a post office do to your packages? Two things.
Lose your packages.
That's one thing they do. The other thing is they crush them and break them. Crush and break. I don't want to make you feel bad, Claudia.
But you just did. And she's ahead.
Yes. All right, David.
I really feel foolish now.
But you don't have hers or any of the two I've mentioned?
No, I went the other way that Claudia went. She said they opened them, and I said that they automatically wrapped.
Wrapped them. Yeah.
Is that bad?
Well, I would
you
dare
get away with it, David.
Venture, yeah, that's right. venture that neither you nor Claudia understood the question. Here we go, Matt. Did you understand it?
Yes, sir, I did.
Bail me out of this.
Crush.
Crush, yes. Crush or lose. All right. Now, Claudia, you're still ahead. However, Sherry can tie it with one, win it with two. Let's see where this game goes. Marvin said, during the nude Miss America contest, it was easy to recognize Miss Alaska. She was the one with the frostbitten blanks. Nedra, Terry, and Matt are the three who play. Ready up there. Ready down here. Sherry. Marvin said during the nude Miss America contest, it was easy to recognize Miss Alaska. She was the one with the frostbitten blanks.
Boobs?
Whoa! Okay. One will win and two will tie.
I thought it was clever.
I don't know what I'm talking about. Two will win and four will tie. Nedra?
Boobs.
Boobs.
Thank you.
All right. Score is now tied, and I guess we've come to the right place for this episode.
I think you're
No, I have refrained all week.
Well, I didn't say boobs.
You didn't say boobs.
No, I said boobies.
Boobies. That wins the game. Thanks for being on the match game. I'm going to send some gifts your way. Claudia Mueller, ladies and gentlemen. Hey there. Congratulations to you. Now we're going to switch to Hollywood Squares. We're bringing the rest of the scenery in here. Three celebrities will make an appearance here as if by magic in a moment. John and I will trade places. I will sit down. He will stand up. Lots more excitement coming along. Don't go away.
Please receive Quasar microwave ovens that reduce cooking times and power settings automatically in the Instamatic oven. Also defrost by time or weight, furnished by Quasar. And now, it's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Square, our quiz from We Got It Made, Ronnie Urseth, Teri Burghoff.
Here I am with Sherry Lowry, who sells children's shoes, and if baby needs a new pair of shoes, you have an opportunity to win one when you play Hollywood Squares. We also have three brand new celebrities. We have Gary Burghoff. Yeah. And Toyo from We Got It Made, Tom Villard. And Bobby Urseth. Tom Villard, what is about to happen on the show? Something of interest, I believe.
It's a secret, but can I tell? There's trouble. David and Claudia, there's some problems there.
Uh-oh.
And you'll have to see, but it's pretty intense.
And in what brand new time slot are we like to
see? New time slot, people thought we got canceled, but we didn't get canceled. We're on Saturday nights at 9 o'clock.
8 o'clock Central.
Okay. Yeah. So they still got it made Saturday nights at 9 o'clock, and we got it made right now because we're going to play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. Ourselves to defending champion Ron Barnes, who is returning as his second day as $1,475. And yesterday he said he had two large and hairy children?
Yes. Slight.
Yeah, I believe you said that. And then on Ugly Blank on the Supermatch, you said ugly girl, right? As opposed
right.
to possibly like ugly duckling. You're getting some flack from your large and hairy children, Ron?
Lots of hair.
Okay, well, you still did okay because you are a defending champ, and you can make up for it today on Hollywood Squares as we play again. Now, we're going to play this game until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever's ahead at that point, logically, is our winner. Goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000. First game is worth $100, $25 for every square that either of you may capture. Our champion always gets to start. That's you, Ron. Pick a star and let's go.
I'd like Nedra, please.
Okay.
I like you, too.
Nedra Volz. In a Ladies' Home Journal article, what does financial expert Sylvia Porter suggest as one way to save money when you're dining out? Should you drink your booze before you leave your house, or try to order from the children's menu?
Which should you do or which shouldn't you do?
Which should you do to save money?
Oh, wow. I always like to order from the children's menu. It's cheaper and everything. And I don't really drink booze. Well, you know. I think if you're kind of needing in money, you know, need money and you shouldn't spend too much, I think if you're going to do any drinking, do it at home. And then order from the adult's menu, for goodness sakes.
Ron Nedra says that to save money when you're dining out, you should drink your booze before you leave your house. Agree or disagree for the first square?
I agree.
You should drink your booze before you leave your house. She knows her booze. Okay, you got the first fair run. Good going. And X goes up there. You are playing O, Sherry Lowry, and it's your move.
Gene?
Gene Rayburn.
Yes.
Which came first, Gene, the first auto accident or the first ambulance?
There couldn't be an accident unless there were automobiles. There couldn't be an ambulance unless there was something to collect in them. Obviously. Well, now, wait a minute. No, there were ambulances. Hold everything.
It's dawning
on
you.
There were horse-drawn ambulances in the Civil War. Those were ambulances. So I would say the ambulances came before the automobiles.
Agree or disagree, Sherry?
I agree.
The ambulance came before the first auto accident. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square. And right on the nose, 1865, the first ambulance in the Civil War. First auto accident, 1896, after autos were invented, logically enough. Ron, your move.
Leah, please.
Okay. Leah Ayres. According to Mr. Rogers, Leah, is it a good thing to tell your kids about the Tooth Fairy, or should you avoid doing that?
No, I think that you should tell them about the Tooth Fairy. I mean, Mr. Rogers tells kids stories and to, activate their imagination, and that's a good thing to do.
So it's a good idea to tell them about your kids about the Tooth Fairy. Ron, agree or disagree?
Even large and hairy children.
Sorry.
You still agree? Yes. Well, it's a beautiful day in your neighborhood, Ron, because it's a good idea to tell your kids about the Tooth Fairy. According to Mr. Rogers, you get the square, and you get $25 and you're ahead. Okay, Sherry, pick a star.
Tom DeBlock.
Tom DeBlock. You missed this one. Ron takes the first game.
What?
Doesn't really involve you, Tom.
I can't see what's going on.
Let's try to answer the question.
Okay, I'm ready.
Oh, this could be about someone you know. Murray the Praying Mantis. He has just spotted an available female.
Yes.
Now, does Murray immediately leap on her, or does he slowly creep up?
Isn't she the one that's going to eat him after they do it? I think praying to mantis is, I'd creep up if I were you. Actually.
Agree or disagree, Sherry? He says that Murray the praying mantis will slowly creep up.
I agree.
He slowly creeps up, and I suppose that applies to most praying mantises other than Murray. You get the square and you do block. We get to come back and complete our $100 game after these messages. Stay put.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Square.
Okay, it's 50-50. 50 for you. Do you want to stop right here, call it a tie?
No way.
I didn't think you did. It's your move, Ron.
Okay, I'd like Gary, please.
Oh, Gary Burghoff?
Yeah.
Sorry, I didn't hear you. Okay, Gary Burghoff for an X. He once said, if I had my life to live over again, I'd like to have ended up as a sports writer. Is he Richard Nixon or Richard Simmons?
That was Richard Nixon during the period when he lost the governorship to California.
He says it was Richard Nixon who made that statement. Ron, agree or disagree?
I agree.
Richard Nixon it was. You're right to agree. Okay, Sherry Lowry, you're playing O. Make your move.
I'll take Matt to block.
You missed this one. The game belongs to Ron. Matt.
Yes, sir.
You're drinking a beer, and yes, it's lost its head.
The praying mantis.
Much like the praying mantis earlier, yes. What should you do to make it foamy again? Add some salt or blow into it through a straw?
Well, if you're drinking a beer with a straw, you should see somebody, I think. So you wouldn't have a straw there. I'd have to say go with the salt.
Okay. Says you should add some salt to that beer that's lost its head. To block, do you agree or disagree, Sherry?
I disagree.
You should add some salt. You should have agreed with Matt. Your opponent gets a square and wins the first game. Okay. Good win for you, Ron. That gives you $200. 50 for you, Sherry. So far, but it really is early yet because we're going to clear the board, wipe out all those X's and O's, and move right on to the next game. This one is worth $200, $25 for every square that you capture. Since the last game was won by Ron, that means that Sherry gets to start this one.
I'll go with Nedra.
Okay. I'd love to go with Nedra. You're the average rich man's wife, Nedra. According to Dr. Joyce Brothers, who is thinner, you or the average poor guy's wife?
Well, I've been both. I mean, thin and fat is what I mean. I think possibly the poor man's wife would be fatter. No matter what you can eat, even if it's grass, I mean, whatever.
She says the average poor man's wife is thinner.
Who is thinner?
Yeah, so...
Thinner. Oh.
Oh, that's right. She said the average poor man's wife
different
is fatter, meaning the average rich man's wife is
different
thinner.
Story.
Correct?
Huh?
Let's start this over again. Who's thinner, Nedra, the average rich guy's wife or the average poor guy's wife?
I think the average rich guy.
Right. Okay, she says the average rich guy's wife is thinner. Agree or disagree, Sherry?
I'll agree.
The average rich man's wife, it is. You're right to agree. You get the square. Okay, Ron, you'd probably like to put an average X in an average square. Pick a better than average star.
I'd like Bonnie, please.
Bonnie Urseth, first time today.
Yes.
What does Gloria Vanderbilt say is the greatest pleasure of all, Bonnie? Making love or getting a manicure?
Gloria Vanderbilt probably thinks it's a manicure. I don't know. I'm gonna say a manicure.
Okay. You're right to Bonnie, Gloria. Ron, she says that Gloria Vanderbilt says that getting a manicure is the greatest pleasure of all. Do you agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Making love, she says, is the greatest pleasure of all. Yes, in this case, you're right to disagree. You do get the square. Yeah. Okay, an X and an O are up there, Sherry, and it's your move.
I'll go with Tom.
Tom Villard. Which came first, Tom, Shelley Winters or Porky Pig?
Oh, don't.
Who knows? Wait, no, I know. I would think that it would be probably... Porky's been around a long time. He doesn't age on television, but I think he's been around since I was before that. No, he was before. I think definitively Porky Pig speakingly. Definitive. Porky Pig.
That he makes... says that Porky Pig came before Shelley Winters. Agree or disagree, Sherry?
I disagree.
Shelley Winters came before Porky Pig. You were right to disagree. Shelley Winters, by 13 years, she beat that Porky. Okay, we're going to beat it for just a minute. We're going to come back and complete the $200 game after this. Two O's and an X. You are playing X, Ron. You're the defending champ, and it's your turn.
Leah to block, please.
You miss this one. Sherry forges into the lead. Leah Ayres, who's older, Brooke Shields or the Barbie doll?
Oh, that's easy. The Barbie doll has been around a long time. Much older than Brooke Shields.
Agree or disagree, Ron?
I agree.
The Barbie doll is older. You're right to agree, and you do get the square. Barbie is not difference. Barbie, 1959. Brooke, 1965. Okay, Sherry, he thwarted you there.
I'll go with David.
David Oliver from Another World.
Yes.
Okay.
It's cute.
Why am I blinking up here?
It's surefire material, David, I'm telling you.
Yeah, I'm used to it.
You're driving along in the country, and you think you see a goat climbing into a tree. Do goats climb trees, or are you just crazy?
Well, if I saw a goat climbing a tree, I'd be in trouble. Goats climb rocks, they don't climb trees. I would say you'd be crazy.
Agree or disagree, Sherry?
I agree.
Goats climb trees. You should have disagreed with David. Your opponent gets that square. Okay, that is a bit of a break, although it's a kind of confused looking board. Pick a star, Ron.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn. By the process of elimination, that's you.
Me.
Which of these came first, Gene? The discovery of vitamin E or the first zipper?
close. They occurred about the same time. The first zipper was invented, I believe. The zipper was invented around in the early 20s, but vitamin E was discovered before that. However, not used therapeutically until long after that, in the early 30s.
So vitamin E, you're saying,
right,
was discovered before the zipper was invented.
Correct.
Vitamin E came first.
Yes, doctor.
Agree or disagree, Ron?
I agree.
The zipper came before vitamin E. You should have disagreed in this case.
Gotcha.
Vitamin E was discovered in 1922, and zippers were first made in 1893. Okay, Sherry.
Gary.
Your move.
No.
Gary Burghoff.
Now I'm on blink.
For an O. Gary, who is older? The painting Whistler's mother or Nedra Volz?
Oh, that's a rotten question.
Whistler's mother, actually. You're talking about the painting, not the subject of Whistler's mother.
The actual painting, yeah. Whistler's mother.
Whistler's mother is not actually that old. That's a 20th century piece, so I would say that...
I wasn't born in the 18th century.
Don't understand. I mean, I know that...
I don't understand.
I know that Miss Darling Lady is also a 20th century piece, but... I didn't mean it in that way. In fact, I didn't mean it in the other way either. What I'm trying to say is that the painting, yeah, Whistler's mother is younger. It's really a rather modern...
So Nedra's older.
What am I trying to say?
You're trying to say...
Help me out, will you, please?
You're trying to say Nedra Volz is older than Whistler's mother.
Yes.
Do you agree or disagree, Sherry?
Neither are of any great advance.
I agree.
Yeah. Are you 112, Nedra? Whistler's mother is older than Nedra Volz. No. Opponent gets that square.
He's going to deck him.
Okay. Now, what that means is that four X's are up on the board for you, Ron Barnes. You need just one more according to our game rules. Five of any symbol wins the game, whether there are three in a row or not. Ron, pick a star.
Matt, please.
Matt McCoy.
To win.
To win.
To win.
Matt, if you took every copy of Playboy magazine ever printed and you gave one to each and every man in China, would you have leftover magazines or leftover men?
Hate leftover men.
Warmed up, they're not bad.
Let me see. Playboy just celebrated the 30th anniversary. Times 12 is not a whole lot, so I think you'd have leftover men.
You'd have leftover men.
Yeah.
Okay, do you agree or disagree, Ron, for the game?
Trust me, Ron.
I agree.
You would have leftover magazines. No, you should have disagreed, and your opponent gets that square. There are 1.3 billion Playboy magazines and about half a billion Chinese men. Okay, new life for you, Sherry. You now have four O's up on the board. What that means is that there are four X's, four O's. You get this next question right, you win the game. You miss it, Ron wins. Pick your star just as a formality, right? As a formality, and, you know, for these guys to get a little further work out. According to Psychology Today, Teri, when a woman meets another woman, what is she more likely to notice first? The other woman's face or her clothes?
Oh, that's a tough one. It is a tough one. It is tough. Who did this? Who's saying that?
Psychology Today.
Oh.
Love their clothes in Psychology.
What's a woman more likely to notice about another woman first, face or clothes?
Oh, gosh. I'll say clothes.
For the game, Sherry, agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
She's more likely to notice her clothes. You should have agreed with Teri. Your opponent gets the square and wins the game. Join Gene Rayburn, get set for your shot at the big money. This is it. You remember, Tim, you still won. His knees are shaking. Mine are too. That's about as close as you can come. Yeah, we had a feeling that time was running down right at that point. It came down to one question. You didn't get it, but you played very, very, very well. You're leaving here with $150, Sherry Lowry, and our thanks.
Right there in here, Steve. Congratulations once again to Ron. We'll be back with him and our nine celebrities. And it goes to big money right after this.
All right. Here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gene Wood. Well, Ron, you've been through this before. You know what the routine is. And you know that you could win up to $30,000 here. Good luck to you. You've got to do it today. That's an order, okay? Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, said, write down your best answer to this. Blank heads. $1,000 for the most popular answer, $500 for the second most popular, and $250 for the third. Now, let's see. Call on the stars, one at a time, and see what sort of assistance you're going to get now. Bonnie, please. Bonnie, what do you say now? Think
talking
about
heads?
This. What? I can't
talking
hear
talking heads.
Talking heads. All right. There, you got one now. Gary, please.
Oh, dear.
Gary Burghoff, what do you say about this?
This is,
talking...
bank heads. I don't know what I'm...
Talking... I beg your pardon. Blank heads, yes. Bonnie said talking heads.
Blank heads. I'm afraid a sad fact of American life. Coke heads, that's all I can think of.
Coke heads, all right. Now you've got two.
John, please.
John, what do you put in that blank? Blank heads.
John.
I'll say swelled heads.
Swell heads.
Yeah.
All right, those are the three they've given you. Now, Ron, you have to think it over and decide whether you want to use one of their answers or think up one of your own. They've given you, to repeat, talking heads, coke heads, and swell heads. What is your pleasure here?
I think I'd like to go with my own and go cabbage heads.
Go what?
Cabbage heads.
Cabbage heads.
Yeah.
See,
is that... What does that mean, right?
Cabbage head.
It's dog. A head of cabbage.
Oh.
Cabbage pants.
A head of cabbage.
It's cabbage.
I think about that frequently.
See.
Okay.
Somebody.
Let's see how you do with the cabbage head.
You old cabbage head, Ron.
All right, Ron. The $250 response says...
cabbage head.
Okay, never would have guessed.
I had this faintest idea in the world that answer was going to be. And neither did you? No, don't give me that.
Figureheads.
All right, what do you think is going to be up there
next? Number
sleepy
one.
Heads.
Sleepy heads.
Cone heads.
Sleepy heads.
Slide the $500.
Pinheads.
Redheads.
Redheads, sure.
All right, what's number one?
Talking.
Talking heads.
Figure.
Go.
Look at these guys.
Talking.
Talking. Okay. That was Bonnie's answer.
For the blank expression that you guys, yeah. You both had a blank expression. It's a rock group. Talking Heads,
Talking
is a rock group. That's
they're
why.
Terrific.
It's a what?
A rock group.
All right. It's strange that these 800 people from the local Hadassah would come in here and say, Talking Heads. I don't understand that. Or 100 little old ladies from Upper Montclair, New Jersey. Anyway... You got $250. Now it's time for the head-to-head match. You're going to choose a star. And after you've made your selection, that star will reveal the hidden number. It can be a 10, a 20, or a 30. There's one 30 up there. It's a bunch of 10s and 20s. We will multiply the $250 by whatever number has been revealed. Okay, Ron, it's time now to make your pick.
Leah, please.
All right, Leah, grab that tab and give it a yank. It's a 20. So 20 times 250 gives you $5,000. That's what you're playing for. Okay, good luck, Ron. Here we go, Leah. Mission blank. No help from the audience. If we hear an answer, we're going to throw it out and start all over. Thank you, and it's got to be an exact match. Mission blank. Now, Leah's ready, Ron. It's up to you to collect the $5,000 to match her. How do you do that?
Impossible.
Mission impossible. He says that'll get the money, Leah. What do you say?
Well, I wish I could have matched you, Ron.
Mission accomplished.
I thought of Mission Impossible, but then I decided on Mission Accomplished.
Did you think of Mission Impossible?
I thought of Mission Impossible first thing, but then I thought, since you didn't say talking heads and stuff, maybe you, you know, like, weren't into, like, TV shows or something like that, or I don't know what.
You mean Ron isn't hip?
I thought maybe you'd say Mission Accomplished. Oh, I really thought about it, Ron. I'm sorry.
All right. Well, Ron, as I said yesterday, you've gained on it a little bit. You're now up to $2,250, and you're going to play again tomorrow, okay? We'll be back right after these messages. Here we go now. We're going to reveal the big 3-0. If you would, stars, everybody grab the tab and give it a pull. 1, 2, 3. Where is the big 3-0? Let's go. Gary Burghoff. All right. Thank you, stars. See you tomorrow. See you tomorrow, Ron. Gene Raven inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Valentine saying so long for the match game. Hollywood Square is ours.
Jurgensen, elegantly styled watches, ladies' sports analogs with rectangular cake, 6 diamonds, and mesh bracelet. Plus a gent sports analog day date in a carat clad case with matching bracelet, furnished by Jules Jurgensen. This is Gene Root speaking for the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour. I'm Mark Goodson. Television production.